Okay, we have a Maytag top load washer model number MVWC6ESWW1. Today we're going to do the normal cycle. We're going to wash the 15 shirts. Let's take a look at the control panel. A little bit closer look here. Okay. So the normal cycle is going to be on this first quadrant here between 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock position. We're going to turn it to, it says express. I'm not sure what that really means. See that right there? Okay, and soil level, we're going to go ahead and do heavy. Extra rinse is going to be on. And fabric softener added. So we're going to turn that on to the far right. And water temperature is going to be warm. So it's going to be a warm wash, cold rinse. Okay, so this is a haul off washer. This is pretty unusual washing machine. It is the direct drive, but it's in the era of the automatic water level Energy Star era. So it's going to be kind of unique in operation compared to what's being sold today. I wish I would have continued with this design because it's everybody knows how to work on them as far as like the mechanics, the pump and the motor. The coupling and all that stuff, but I guess they couldn't keep it. So let's take a look at this drum, stainless steel drum, really nice, dual action agitator. It does have the dog ears, so you have this single direction type agitation up on top. It has some kind of a mechanism to detect water levels. So let's see if we can figure that out. And we did, I looked up sales on this. Somebody mentioned it was like a 2000, I think a 9 or 2011. We sold some of these washers. I looked in our sales logs and I found that we sold like 4 units back in 2010. So, and you know, back when we're sales people, you know, we see the new models come out. All we know is capacity. We know, you know, cycles, but we don't know what the real changes were, what they did in the engineering department. So, you know, it to us, it looked like a standard washer as salespeople. But really, this was, you know, quite different from what was, 10 years prior to that. And this could be normal, I'm not sure. I don't want to order a part for it. I don't want to put a timer in it and it does the same thing. I don't think it's really worth it. I think it's good for parts and that's about it. Let me get a little bit closer. Okay. So to get this started on the timer, traditional style timer, you just pull it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so it looks like we're done. All right, let's take a look at the finished product. Spin dries, not too bad. Please post your comments. Please let me know what you think about the machine. We'll probably do maybe one or two more wash loads with this one. You see how it performs. Then we'll send it on its way. I gave this washer away to one of the scrap metal guys. He wanted this washer, and so I told him, let me film it first, and then he could have it. So anyway, so hopefully it goes to a better home. And take care. We'll see you next time.